Before we show you a computationally more feasible way of proving theorems in logic or proving the truth value of sentences in logic, we should point out that so far we have been using only propositional logic. Propositional logic is sometimes also called the zeroth order logic. The key aspect of propositional logic is that it does not have any variables. So as an example, I may have a sentence which says, if the animal lays eggs and the animal flies, then the animal is a bird. And here I'm talking about a specific animal. But sometimes I might want to talk about animals in general, any animal, all animals. In that case, I would want to introduce variables in it. So in first order logic, also known as predicate calculus, I might want to say something like, if X lays eggs and X flies, then X is a bird, which has a form very similar to the form here, except that instead of animal, I now have a variable. Now, I have a variable here, but I must also specify the range of the variable. And what I really want to say here is for all animals. Therefore, I'll introduce a new quantifier over the variable X. This quantifier is called a universal quantifier. It is generated with this symbol. This is a symbol for a universal quantifier. And this says now, for all X, if X lays eggs and X flies, it implies that X is a bird. One thing to note here is that I could have rewritten this sentence with a universal quantifier back into propositional logic by having lots of sentences like this in propositional logic. So I could have said lays eggs, animal one, flies, animal one, implies bird, animal one, lays eggs, animal two, and flies, animal two, implies bird, animal two, and so on and so forth for each and every animal that is possible. But by writing it in the form of a variable and universal quantifiers in it, I can reduce the number of sentences I have to write into just one sentence. So we've introduced variables, and we have talked at least about one quantifier so far, the universal quantifier, that applies for all values that that variable can take. Sometimes I might want to specify a different range of the variable. Not all values that the variable can take, but at least some values that the variable might can take. So consider again this sentence. Here the animal is referring to a specific animal. Now let us look at the second sentence on the screen. And this sentence is the variable y. It says that if y lays eggs and y flies, then it implies that y is a bird. This sentence is a very similar form to the previous sentence except for the variable y. I can specify the value that the variable y can take. This time I want to specify not that this sentence is true for all values of y, for all animals, but supposing I want to say that it is true for some, at least one animal, in which case I'll use an existential quantifier. Here is a symbol for an existential quantifier. This existential quantifier says that there is at least one animal for which this sentence happens to be true.